This question came in 1983, year when Sai Mihir got born. Okay, can you tell me one thing? Their top surface, do they remain at the same level? Yes or no? They'll remain at the same level because at the top, it is atmospheric pressure, right? The pressure is same. So along horizontal line only, pressure will remain same if horizontally the system is not accelerating. Okay, so they both have to be in the same level. If they are not, let us say right hand side liquid is slightly more, then pressure over here will be atmospheric pressure plus rho gh of this liquid. But that is not the thing. Pressure both side has to be atmospheric pressure. Now let us say second liquid is up till here. So from here I can draw a line like this. Okay, then since it is a horizontal line, pressure over here, let's say, is P1. Pressure here, let's say, is P2. P1 has to be equal to P2. Okay. Now, P1 is atmospheric pressure plus rho of the second liquid, G into H, where this distance is H. Okay. And P2 is what? P2 is atmospheric pressure plus density of the first liquid, G into H, right? And both of them are equal because they are along the same horizontal line. So since P1 is equal to P2, this implies density of first liquid has to be equal to density of the second liquid. So if specific gravity of first one is 1.1, for the second one also it has to be 1.1. Okay, so like this you have to do, you know, this question. Any doubts on this?
No, sir.
Okay, I'll move to the next question. So you can see there are two questions on your screen. Try attempting both of them. It is written that it's a large open tank. So you can consider that the area of cross section of tank is much more than the area of the holes. So you can use Tauchery's law. What is Tauchery's law? I'll quickly introduce Tauchery's law.
So is it option A?
Wait. If this is area of cross section A and the hole is very small and at a depth y, then the velocity of the liquid that is coming out will be equal to root 2gy. Assuming A is very large compared to small a. So this is Tauchery's law. Remember this. Or you can derive it also, but it is good to remember. Now, quantities of water flowing out is what? Quantity of water that is flowing out per second is nothing but dm by dt. This is mass flow rate, which is rho A into V. Okay. So if density is same, I can say that A1 V1 is A2 V2. This is not continuity equation. But what is given here is that if this is square hole and this is circular hole, A1 V1 here will be equal to A2 V2 there. That is what it means. Okay. If mass flow rate coming out, both sides are same. Okay. Now, the quantities of water coming out is same. Circular hole has radius R and depth 4y. Okay. So, okay, circular is at a depth of 4y. So this will be a square, which is at y. And this will be, let's say, circular, which has a depth of 4y. Okay. So let's say this is V1 and this is V2. Okay. So V1 is root of 2gy. G into 4y is V2. Okay, so this will come out to be 2 times under root 2gy. This is v2. Now, a1 is what? A1 is the area of the square hole which has side length L. So L square is the area. This into v1 under root 2gy1. This should be equal to a1 of the square hole which has radius r is pi r square. This is area of this circular hole. This into velocity of the water coming out from there. Okay, so when you equate it, root 2gy get cancelled out. Okay, and r will come out to be equal to L divided by under root 2 pi. Okay, so many of you have solved these questions before. So others, those who are not able to get it from the first go because you are seeing it for the first time, don't get unnecessarily intimidated by that fact. Okay, so there will be many people who have solved this question 4 or 5 times also at times. Anyways, sixth one, what is the answer? Okay, Vaishnavi is asking how you arrive dm by dt is rho av. Vaishnavi, velocity is what? Meter per second. Okay, when you multiply with area of cross section, you get volume per second. Area into meter per second, volume per second. Okay, now that volume per second, when you multiply with density, so density into volume becomes mass. So then it becomes mass per second. So rho av it comes. So I am telling you in a very crude way, in case you want to get into the details of it, you can refer the notes where we have derived the Bernoulli's theorem. There we have discussed in greater detail. Okay, sixth one, any answer? No one? Should I do it? Okay, let me do this now. There is a hemispherical portion of radius r removed from the bottom of the cylinder of radius r. Okay, so this is a cylinder, hemispherical portion is removed. The volume of the remaining cylinder is V and the mass is M. So volume of the cylinder is given. Okay, it is suspended by the string in the liquid of density rho. It stays vertical. The upper surface is at a depth h. The force on the bottom of the cylinder by the liquid is what? Okay. Aja, first of all, we know that net force due to liquid in this case is what? Buoyant force. Okay, which is what? V rho g, isn't it? This is the net force due to the liquid. Now if you draw free body diagram of this cylinder, due to the liquid there will be a force from the top and there will be a force from the bottom. Okay, there will be sideways force also, but they will get cancelled away. Okay, but these two forces will not get cancelled. All right, so we can say that pressure over here is P1. So P1 into A is the force from the top. But here the problem is that this hemispherical portion, every point is at different depth. So let's just keep it as F only. Okay, we know that net force is V rho g, so F minus P1 into A is V rho g. Okay, and of course there will be this, you might be wondering, what about the force due to the tension which will be from here? Let's say this is tension. Okay, and what about the mg force? So first of all, you need to understand I'm not doing the force balance here. Okay, I am not writing force balance equation. What I am writing here is the force due to the liquid equation. Okay, so force due to the liquid, the net force is in upward direction, that is the buoyant force, which is V rho g. Okay, now this V rho g, you can split it into two components, the force from the top and force from the below. Okay, so this is not force balance. So F will be equal to P1A plus V rho g. Okay, now P1 is not the total pressure here. P1 is just the pressure due to the fluid. Okay, so what I'm trying to say here is that, you know, there will be a atmospheric pressure also here. PA plus rho GH is P1. Okay, so this is P1. Okay, similarly, the atmospheric pressure will be acting from below as well. Okay, but we are trying to find out the force due to the liquid, not because of the atmospheric pressure. Okay, so since when you subtract, the pressure due to the atmosphere will anyway get cancelled away. So I'll just consider the rho GH pressure due to the liquid. Okay, that is simply, yeah, rho GH only, rho GH. So F will become equal to P1 into A. Now A is what? Pi R square. So rho GH into pi R square plus V rho G. This is the answer for the force from the bottom. So option number D. So if you understand this question properly, many concepts will be clear, because here we have actually utilized the fact that buoyant force is the outcome of all the forces because of the fluid. Any doubts on this question? Anything? Fine, let's move to the next one. These two. Okay, so back. So for the seventh, see, you have seen a similar question before also, isn't it? So when the coin is on top of the wooden block, then it is displacing more volume than its own volume, isn't it? So when the coin is at the top of the wooden block, it is displacing more volume than its own volume. Okay, but when the coin fell down, then it is just displacing, you know, it is just displacing volume equal to its own volume. Are you getting it? So earlier it was displacing more volume. Okay, and now it is displacing lesser volume. So H will decrease. H will go down. Are you getting it? Because the water is getting more volume to occupy. So H will reduce. Okay, so what about L? See, L is nothing but this lambda only, which is shown over here. So even this will reduce, because now the wooden block doesn't have to displace more volume. Earlier it was getting compressed below because of coin. Okay, so both H and L will decrease. Why this will increase? Both will decrease, right? What about eighth one? What is the answer for eighth? Seventh answer, D is correct. D for Delhi. All of you understood why seventh D is correct? Type in yes or no. Okay, eighth. Okay, eighth one. So this is showing a graph between delta L and the load that is connected out to the other end. The cross section of the area of the wire is this. Calculate the Young's modulus of the material. So Young's modulus is simply given as sigma divided by epsilon, right? Sigma is what? Force per unit area divided by, this is delta L by L. Okay. So you will get FL divided by A delta L. Now here we have L given as 1 meter. So it is simply F divided by A times delta L is Young's modulus. Okay. And area of cross section is also given. So Young's modulus is simply F by delta L multiplied by 10 raised to the power 6. So I think this is a straightforward question where F is 20 newtons, okay, and delta L is 10 raised to the power minus 4, this into 10 raised to the power 6. So you'll get 2 into 10 raised to the power 11, A is the correct answer, okay. At times they will give you just rather than weight, they can give you mass. So you need to multiply that with G also. All right, so we'll move to the next one. Any doubt, guys, please type in case you have any doubts. No doubts.